Nathan's dad looks like he's really laying into him. I wonder what it's about.
So Nathan is bullied and then becomes a bully himself.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me. And the football team will just bully me more.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
But Dad...
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name.
You what about you, huh?
You will not embarrass me. Nathan.
Yes.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Hi, we totally weren't listening to you. What's up, Mr. Prescott, sir?
Great pep talk, Mr. P. Everyone knows the best way to instill confidence in someone is by intimidating them.
I don't know who you are, but mind your own business.
Never.
I'd love to. Don't you have, like, a private bunker filled with gold coins where you could have these conversations?
Good day, sir. I said good day. Just trying to help. In our own screwed up way. Break a leg. Oops. Oh, that went well.
Samantha seems pretty torn up about what happened between Nathan and his dad.
Hey, we'll talk about it.
Nathan's dad is some asshole, huh?
I know. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
Kind of tough. That is his father. You should be careful.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Yep.
Oh, Chloe, I wasn't thinking. I'm sorry.
Her dad went away.
For what? You didn't kill my dad.
Empathy.
You?
What?
That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's. Actually, the two of you are really similar.
What the hell does that mean?
Don't know
I'm
how to
serious.
Take that one.
You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. I think you stood up for Nathan yesterday because you know what he's going through. Nathan's hurt, and he needs help. But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse. If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
Well, it's not like what I did helped him. Give him up, give him help. Are they dating or something? I mean, I don't know what the issue here is. Give him space, I think, at least right now. He seems to need it.
When I'm super angry, I need to let it all out. The last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down. Case in point, how pissed he was when we tried to help him yesterday.
True.
If I were you, I'd give him space and wait for him to come to you.
That actually makes sense. Thanks, Chloe.
No problem. Does she have anything else to say when she looks at it? Let's see. Oh. I forgot how to do it.
I should. Samantha may be the only person in the world who really cares about Nathan. Including Nathan's dad.
Yep, sad to say.
Wouldn't want to leave the great wall of bitchiness back in the drama lab, I guess.
I'm trying to read it. R.A. will suck as press bearer on Rachel Amber. If V.C. Victoria... What's her last name? Forget. But it's gotta be... If Victoria had any trouble, maybe she... Have any talent, maybe she would have gotten the talent. The part. Carry a talent. Is that what you got Mr. K to cast you, slut? Nice. Okay, so Rachel Amber is either in here. In here.
Boys changing tent. Thanks, but no thanks.
Okay. Then she is in the other one.
No way in hell. Oh, yeah, I'm not going to stay on that stage.
I was just kind of trying to go forward at that point. Let me go. Okay. So I'm guessing she's in there. Oh god.
Where would Rachel be right now?
I don't understand. This is invisible barrier. And for some reason I know I have to click a left button.
Rachel?
Oh, there we go. You answer when I call you. Oh, is that Victoria? That's Victoria. Peek-a-boo. What are you doing? Making tea? Or putting something in tea? Oh, you've got two of them. Oh. Oh. She's gonna drug Rachel Amber. Switch them.
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit.
Switch the cups. We gotta switch the cups.
I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
Yep. Frank. Frankie boy. Frankie goes to Hollywood. Okay, I'm trying to get to the... Come on. I just talked to Damon, he says. I can't get to... Oh god, this is so annoying. Are you done? I just talked to Damon. Good work. You can meet me tomorrow to pick up your cut. Okay, so what? His boss came to pick it up instead. So these guys don't communicate or something? Your friend's an asshole. What matters is he's happy. Whatever. Price, you did the right thing. Well, thank you. I didn't need your approval, but... Oh, fancy schmancy. I see a Chloe. I can empty the purse?
Only the finest child slave labor for Victoria Chase.
Yeah, because the thing's in there. Can I... I can't switch the cups? I want to switch the cups. Let's look at a note first.
Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage.
See me or Mr. K for makeup kits, SG.
I'm not leaving until I figure out what Victoria's up to.
Yes, and taking a look at these costumes.
I haven't seen this much spandex since Mom made me go to that Zumba class with her.
That spandex looks like coats and stuff.
Even though Steph's not here, her sticky still laid down the law.
Wardrobe and makeup by 6 p.m. Oh, Raven mask, like we saw in our dream.
Hey kids, who wants to dress up like Big Bird's fugly cousin? I wouldn't be caught dead in this.
I guess that's why you're not in the drama club.
Okay, this mask is actually pretty sweet. I hope Rachel gets to wear it.
Ariel. And Prospera. Right, isn't she playing the part of Prospera? Miranda. Do I have to look at the scene list? It's probably going to yell at me because I'm trying to leave. It thinks I'm going to leave. Okay, so the only thing I can really do, I can't switch the cups. Unless you never know whether they're
what
both...
What was Victoria up to?
Both drugged. What's that say? Good luck, Amber. You are a star. I am invincible. Believe in yourself. I do. I don't know. Something... I can't read that. Alright, let's empty the purse. See what we got in here. Pills. Portfolio. Look at that first.
Victoria Chase is actually a pretty talented photographer. Why does that piss me off so much?
Because you don't want to like her for anything or see value in anything she does. It means makes her more of like a cool person or something. That Principal Wells looking at this? What? Why? He looks like distressed. Oh. It's like, oh my god, it looks too much like me. What am I gonna do with my life? Okay, photographing birds. Photographing birds. Okay, done. We got pills. What kind of pills we got here?
Muscle relaxers?
Soma? Caris? Carisoprodol? Something? 100 tablets. She put it in the tea.
Coming, Rachel. Hurry now before your tea gets... What are you doing here?
Less drugged?
This area is for cast and crew only. Or are you only here to try and sabotage the play like you sabotaged my homework? God, you're pathetic.
Oh, I thank you. What a sweetie. I'm here for Rachel.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
Yes, yes.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever. Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night. As a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this bag.
Don't drink it.
May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks?
It's drugged. Tell Rachel.
Wait up, Rachel. Bitch, dosed your tea.
Excuse me? How dare you?
How dare
Victoria,
you?
Victoria, could this possibly be true?
You can't drug people, Victoria.
Of course not. A dropout Chloe is clearly directing her misplaced anger at me.
So drink it, Victoria.
I'm sorry your life is a mess, but it's not my fault, okay?
Drink the other one, Victoria.
Chloe, Victoria is my friend. She would never do anything to sabotage me.
Switch the cups. Then she should drink the tea.
Then she should prove it. Drink the tea.
What?
I wouldn't dare insult Victoria's integrity like that.
What integrity?
Then again, if that's what it'll take to convince you that Victoria is a good and caring person, fine. Come on, Vic.
Yeah.
Drop out Chloe in her place once and for all.
I thought Rachel was going to drink the tea. I'm like, no, I mean Victoria drink it. Come on, drink it. That's the not drugged one. That's the one you had. Drink the one that you were giving to her. Unless that's it.
Oh, happy?
You didn't drink
so
any of it.
Happy.
Check the cup.
Whatever. If you're done accusing me of things, I'll just be on my way. Bitches.
You gotta hurry up before you pass out.
Wow. Saved my ass again. Price. All in a day's work. And this has been a particularly batshit crazy day.
Just like yesterday.
The show is ruined.
She passed out.
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel.
Oh.
Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, Devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel. Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Oh god, give it a rest. There you go, now it's worse.
Touché.
What?
Ready to ditch this dump?
No.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No what? Fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
Oh, we don't know the lines.
The romantic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
We don't know any
she
of the lines.
Indeed.
We have
tell
not
me,
rehearsed.
Dear, have you ever acted before?
No.
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time.
All
and
the time.
She's fantastic at it.
Once.
What if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
I'd say sayonara, production.
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
Even better. We don't know the lines? What are you gonna do, read it off a card?
Damn it.
Seriously? She gets to wear the thing.
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
She said no way would she wear this thing. And now she's wearing it. Well, gotta take a good look. Look at those skinny legs. Sheesh. Alright. The script. Okay.
I seriously have to memorize all of this? Thanks, Rachel.
We have to... Do I have to memorize it? Like myself? Because, how many minutes do we have to wait it starts? The Tempest, Act 1, Scene 1. Prospero. By accident, most strange, beautiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to the shore. Prospero cast sleep over Miranda. Here cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Miranda falls asleep. Come away, servant, come. I am ready now. Approach my Ariel, come. Enter Ariel. And Ariel says, all hail, great master. I come to answer thy best pleasure. All right. All hail, great master. I come to answer thy best pleasure. Oh, there's more. Act 1, Scene 2. This is... Act 1. It's still Act 1, Scene 2. Same act. Same scene. Prospero. Hast thou, spirit, performed to point the tempest that I bade thee? Is this a real play, or is this made up for the game? Ariel says, I boarded the king's ship, and every cabin I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble. I flamed I'm trying to, like, kind of memorize this. I don't know if I have to. Prospero says, my brave spirit, who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason? Ariel says, not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped, cried, hell is empty, and all the devils are here. That's the name of the third episode, Hell is Empty. Coming soon to a computer or a Let's Play channel near you. Prospero says, but are they, Ariel, safe? Ariel flies to the shipwreck and points. She says, not a hair perished, and as thou badest me, I have dispersed them about the isle in troops. Prospero says, Ariel, thy change exactly is performed, but there's more work. Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised. Prospero says, how now? What is it? What is to thou canst demand? How do you say that? Ariel says, my liberty. Prospero says, before the time be out? No more. Yet be correspondent to command, and after 2 days I will discharge thee. Ariel says, that's my noble master. Prospera says, "Go, make thyself like a nymph of the sea. Go, take this shape, and hither come it, in it. Go, hence with diligence. Ariel exits." I have to memorize this stuff. "All hail, great master, I come to answer thy best pleasure." So I see she summoned this. Like a servant. A servant of the air. Right? The bird thing. Birds fly in the air. Okay. "I boarded the king's ship in every cabin. I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks..." Well, maybe she commands fire as well? "Of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bull waves tremble. Who is so firm that this coil would not affect..." Not a soul. "The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped," cried. "Hell is empty." "Are they safe? Not a hair perished. I dispersed them about the island troops. Is there more toil?" My liberty. Okay. I have a general idea of what we have to say. Trying to get up here. "Chloe, the show is starting. We got great seats. Where are you?" "Oh, you'll see." Question marks. "You sure will. Keep a lookout for Ariel." There's the backside of Ariel. She's never going to live this down. Unfortunately, no one ever mentions it afterwards. Or at least when Max comes back.
"By accident most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to this shore. Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant. Come."
Ah, shit. Makeup.
I'm on.
That's you.
"I am ready now.
Get out there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come."
Damn it. "No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
Or I can look at a rock.
I wish I could throw that at Rachel for getting me into this."
Got a crate?
"Hey, I sat here yesterday.
Dazzled by the lights.
Ugh, that killed my eyes."
We can just walk around and look at everything even though people are waiting.
"Sick lightning. I bet Elamon could cast that."
It is totally unrealistic.
"I'm definitely supposed to do something with this."
You board it or something. And you set the people free in troops so they don't die. Something like that.
"I want to play her part."
Just lay there.
"Rachel looks way too pleased with herself for getting me into this."
Maybe she's supposed to look pleased at this point in the act.
"All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure."
Oh my
"Most
god.
Most fearless, generous spirit. Hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?"
"I boarded the king's ship."
"I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin, I flamed amazement."
Oh my gosh, she's horrible.
"The fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most Mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble.
My brave spirit.
Good God.
Who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried.
Why is she talking like that? Hell is empty.
Cried, hell is empty, and all the devils are here.
She'd be better just talking like herself.
But are they, Ariel? Safe?
All right. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
To the shipwreck?
I'm definitely supposed to do something with this.
Oh, Chloe, stand here. Chloe, stand here. Okay, here we go. Left mouse button.
Not a hair perished. And as thou battest me, I have dispersed them about the isle.
In troops.
In troops.
Bravo.
Ariel.
Seriously,
thy talk
bravo?
Exactly is performed. But there's more work.
More toil?
Is
more
there
lines.
More toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
Oh, it should be IS without a space. Liberty. I'm really tempted to do the other lines just to see what the hell happens. It must be hilarious. But I kind of want to get it right.
My liberty.
Indeed.
Thy liberty?
Yep.
Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
What?
That's not her line.
Yeah.
Is it? What's going on?
That's not what you're supposed to say. But thou hast promised?
But thou assured my freedom. Didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped.
It is?
Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress.
It is.
Most truly, it is so.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script.
What is acting?
It's magical.
Best line so far.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
What do I choose? What? Excitement isn't happiness? What am I saying there? Excitement will grow old? Excitement, meaning we aren't happy with her? With her being our friend or more or something? Excitement will grow old. I don't know. I'm gonna choose excitement will grow old.
Excitement ages quickly. And I fear if we set out in search of new fun, you'll
fun.
Tire of me. And then I'll be alone.
Aww.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
So come with me.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes, and when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty is forgot.
Did you make
what
all this up just now?
To my most hopeful wish.
I do? Say yes. What are we? Yes. Is she proposing to us? Please. Say yes.
Your duty done for now. So go forth hence with haste. I've work to do.
Okay. Look out, tell me twice.
You crushed it. So good.
Oh, there's the other one.
Born thespian, my dear. I'll be chasing you down next year.
Oh, yeah.
And the ending, absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
I'm born lesbian.
Thanks. What the hell just happened? Strangeness of your story. Was that real? Put heaviness
in me. Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban!
Oh.
Come forth, I say!
On!
He plays the slave? Oh, that's sad. That he has to play that part in addition to everything that's going on?
As wicked do, as e'er my mother brushed.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself. Filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell. Till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
What? What do you do?
Shit.
He's crying.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Don't have everyone laugh at him. God, you
fuck
make...
you.
Oh. How are you making me feel sorry for Nathan Prescott? How is that possible?
Where should this music be? In the air? Or the earth?
Maybe in the water.
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
What really? Is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor!
Is this going by the lines now? I don't even know.
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard, like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves.
Wait, so I guess Ariel didn't have an understudy?
Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands.
I like that. Now I'm going to be looking this up to see if it's a real play. Or script or whatever. We'll trip over the rock. But I want Chloe to go up and bow. No, Chloe doesn't want to do it. Wait, is that Chloe? No, it's Chloe's back there. She doesn't wanna. She's gonna drag her out there.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah?
How dead? Hella dead.
Practically decomposing. So awkward. Encore, encore. Sarah.